Today, students, we will study about, now, as far as structure is concerned, I think that you, you have come to know. I also wrote on the boards. I will also send. I will send you through the notes. Today we will study about how, when we use different tenses. For example, we have studied present indefinite, but we know that in present indefinite we in the affirmative sentence we use verb first form in negative, we use do and does with not and verb first form. So it's quite clear that structure, as far as structure is concerned, I don't think there should be any problem about the structure. So today, now we are going to discuss when we use present indefinite in our day-to-day life, or suppose that if you are asked to write something in English, so it should be clear in your mind that which tense should be used when. Kaun sa tense ka jo use hota hai, kab hum karte hain, taki whenever you are asked to write anything, you can write it in correctly, you can write it in proper manner. So today we will first see when the present indefinite tense is used. So the first point is, students, we use present indefinite for universal truth. We can use present indefinite for universal truth. Suppose that the sun sets in the west, the sun rises in the east, the earth revolves around revolves around the sun. So these are the universal truth, students. The dog barks, birds fly. So these are universal truth for which we can use present indefinite tense. So it should be clear whenever you want to speak about the universal truth, whenever you want to write about universal truth, it should be clear that you can only use which tense for that purpose. You can only use present indefinite. For example, birds fly. So we have used it for we have used present indefinite for this universal truth. You cannot write that birds will fly. We cannot write birds will fly because there is a rules, and rule says that for universal truth we can only use which tense. We can only use present indefinite. So this one is not present indefinite. It means that birds will fly means birds udegi. It means that we are talking about that birds generally do not fly, and in the future time they will, once their time will come, they will start flying. ऐसा टाइम है कि बर्ड उड़ना शुरू कर देगी, ऐसा नहीं है. इट्स यूनिवर्सल ट्रूथ दैट बर्ड्स जनरली फ्लाई. सो फॉर यूनिवर्सल ट्रूथ, स्टूडेंट्स कीप इन माइंड, फॉर यूनिवर्सल ट्रूथ वी कैन यूज प्रेजेंट इंडिफिनिट टेंस. किसका यूज करेंगे हम? प्रेजेंट इंडिफिनिट का यूज करेंगे. यू कैन नोट इट डाउन द पॉइंट्स क्विकली. सेकेंड पॉइंट इज दैट इफ यू वॉन्ट टू टॉक अबाउट और राइट अबाउट द डेली रूटीन ऑफ समबडी, किसी के भी डेली रूटीन के बारे में हम बताना चाहते हैं, लिखना चाहते हैं, लाइक इन योर एट योर होम यू कैन सी रूटीन ऑफ एवरीबडी इज फिक्स्ड. इफ योर फादर इज डूइंग जॉब समवेयर, सो ही मस्ट बी गेटिंग रेडी एट द पर्टिकुलर टाइम, ही मस्ट बी गेटिंग फॉर द जॉब, ही मस्ट बी लिविंग फॉर द जॉब एट द पर्टिकुलर टाइम, ही मस्ट बी रिटर्निंग फ्रॉम द जॉब एट द पर्टिकुलर टाइम. यू हैव द routine of the attending the online class. So whenever you are describing about the daily routine of somebody something, so which tense you will use? You will use present indefinite tense. If you want to say that in a house mother cooks food daily, so it is her routine works. My father leaves for the office at 9 a.m. so it is his routine works. We attend the online class at 8:40, so it is in our routine works. Classes last for 40 minutes, so it is the routine of the class. So everything that comes under the daily routine, we can use for that वी कैन यूज प्रेजेंट इन्फिनिटिव टेंस. डेली रूटीन के बारे में डिस्क्राइब करने के लिए, उसके बारे में बताने के लिए हम किस टेंस का यूज कर सकते हैं? प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट का यूज कर सकते हैं. इट शुड बी क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन नोट इट डाउन योर डाउट्स. आई विल टेक योर क्वेश्चन आफ्टर सम टाइम. सो टू पॉइंट्स वी हैव स्टडीड. फॉर यूनिवर्सल ट्रूथ वी ओनली कैन यूज प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट टेंस. फॉर डेली रूटीन वर्क्स, जो भी हम डेली रूटीन के वर्क्स करते हैं, लाइक आई वेक अप दिस टाइम, देन आई नो get ready for the online class, then I attend the class from this time to that time, then I take food, then I take food. So all these are the parts of daily work, students. So for all these we can use only which tense? Present indefinite tense. Jo bhi hum daily routine ka kaam, daily ka kaam karte hain, like we play cricket at evening or evening at 5 o'clock, so it is the part of our daily routine, so only we can use present indefinite tense. So now let's talk about the third point. Third point is that if you have no commentary, if you listen the commentary, earlier there was time the television was not available, or you can say television were not available. So earlier people used to mostly listen the commentary on radio, and even if you listen the commentary on TV, so you commentator, you might have heard or might have seen that commentators using present indefinite tense generally. Like if I want to describe a commentary or an event in the match, like if I want to say Dhoni dives his left and takes the catch, ball goes into the air, he catches safely. So all these events I can describe only in present indefinite, because we can as far as commentary on radio or on television is concerned, it is also done in present indefinite. Commentary भी जो होती है वो किस टेंस में हम जनरली करते हैं? प्रेजेंट इंडिफिनिट में, चाहे रेडियो कमेंट्री हो चाहे टेलीविजन की पे कमेंट्री हो, सो वो भी प्रेजेंट इंडिफिनिट के यूज से की जा सकती है. इट्स नॉट विजिबल, आई हैव रिटन हियर कमेंट्री स्टूडेंट्स. कमेंट्री के लिए भी हम किसका यूज कर सकते हैं? प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट का यूज कर सकते हैं. नाउ फोर्थ पॉइंट इज स्टूडेंट्स, फोर्थ पॉइंट इज दैट वी कैन आल्सो यूज प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट फॉर न्यूज़पेपर हेडलाइंस. न्यूज़पेपर हेडलाइंस, you must have, if you have read the English newspaper, you must have seen three people injured, he dies in accident, peace talks fail. Suppose that two country are engaging in the bilateral talks, agar do deshon ke beech mein koi vartalap chal raha hai किसी बात को लेकर, एंड इफ इट फेल्स, सो हेडिंग ऑफ द न्यूज़पेपर कुड बी लाइक दिस, पीस टॉक फेल्स. इस तरह से हेडिंग आप न्यूज़पेपर में देख सकते हो, पीस टॉक फेल्स. सपोज द आईपीएल इज अबाउट टू स्टार्ट नेक्स्ट मंथ, सो यू कैन सी द हेडिंग इन द न्यूज़पेपर, आईपीएल स्टार्ट्स नेक्स्ट मंथ. सो एज फार एज न्यूज़पेपर headings are concerned, students, for newspaper headlines, newspaper heading, we can also use present indefinite tense. Hum kiska use kar sakte hain? Present indefinite ka use kiya ja sakta hai. So these points, it are very important to study, students, because suppose that if you don't know when to use present indefinite, so it's become very very difficult task for anyone to use present indefinite properly. So we should now keep in mind all these points, that where we can use present indefinite tense. Ye sabhi points, it would be better for you to remember them, so that whenever you are writing or describing something, you can use the present indefinite tense properly. Aap present indefinite ka use properly kar soke, iske liye bahut zaruri hai. So four point we have studied where we can use present indefinite. Now let's talk about the fifth point. If anything is planned, students, suppose that after summer vacation your school, it is fixed that your school will reopen in July. So if anything is already fixed, date of that event, date of that थिंग इज ऑलरेडी फिक्स्ड, उसका समय पहले से क्या है, फिक्स्ड है, प्लान्ड है. फॉर दैट पर्पज वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ आवर स्कूल इज सपोज टू बी ओपन इन जुलाई, सो यू कैन राइट लाइक दिस, आवर स्कूल. लेट मी फर्स्ट राइट द पॉइंट. फॉर प्लान्ड वर्क, फॉर प्लान्ड वर्क वी कैन यूज प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, our school reopens in July. Suppose that somebody will retire on particular date, so we can else, for that we can also use present indefinite. जैसे मुझे पहले से पता है कि जो हमारे जो suppose that your father is just about to retire on particular day. Your grandfather is about to retire on particular date. For that purpose, we can also use present indefinite. Like this, like for this, we can see this example. My father retires on 15th of July. So, if the date of any event is फिक्स्ड स्टूडेंट्स, किसी भी इवेंट का, किसी भी वर्क का डेट फिक्स है, फॉर दैट वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट. उसके लिए भी हम प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट का यूज कर सकते हैं. दैट इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, देयर इज नो डाउट अबाउट इट. इसके बारे में कोई डाउट आप नहीं होना चाहिए. सो यू कैन नोट इट डाउन, ऑल दिस पॉइंट्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई विल ऑल्सो सेंड इन द ग्रुप. नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट द सिक्स्थ पॉइंट स्टूडेंट्स. Though it is not very important, already we have discussed, like second point was that for daily routine works we use present indefinite. So for daily routine works we can also use these adverb students, adverb of frequency. If you have not studied about adverb, don't be bother about it, because we just going to take some words from the adverb of frequency. Kuch adverb of frequency ke jo word hote hain, which generally used for with the present indefinite, jiska use kiske sath kiya jata hai, present indefinite ke sath, unko hum dekhenge aap. Adverb of frequency, kuch there are words which show the frequency of happening the things. Koi work kaise hota hai, how many times it occurs, uske bare mein dekh lete hain. Like always, sometimes, always, never, twice, usually. So student, with these words, these are the words of frequency, adverb of frequency words. Along with these words, we can generally use our routine works. Like I always wake up at 7 o'clock, so it is my routine that I always wake up at 7 o'clock. So with that I can also use this word always. मैं किसका यूज कर सकता हूँ? Always का यूज कर सकता हूँ. Like I always wake up at, I always attend the class on the time. मैं हमेशा क्लास जो है अटेंड करता हूँ टाइम पे. Sometimes I play cricket in the evening. It is my in routine that I play cricket, but it is not regular, on the regular basis. Sometimes I play cricket. So these words will just add, little bit, it will make your sentence more meaningful. It will give your sentence more clarity about it. I never tell a lie. मैं कभी झूठ नहीं बोलता हूँ. So it is not in my habit. It is not in my routine to tell a lie. So these words, students, you can also use along with your routine works. So now let's talk about the another seventh point, students. After completing all the points where we can now with the where we can use the present indefinite, I will take your question. So if you have doubt, don't be worry about that. I will come to you. You can note it down, your doubts. Let's talk about the seventh point, student. Seventh point is about that with when and whenever words. With when and whenever words, we can describe the works or events that are bound to happen, that naturally happen, that always happens. For example, when I go to Rasda, For example, when I go to Rasada, I do buy books. So it is my routine. It's routine. It's quite a sequence that whenever I will go to Rasada, it is in my work, it routine work, or you can say it is in my habit that I always buy book. So with the help of such words, when and whenever, you can also write such sentences. आप इस तरह का sentence लिख सकते हैं. Whenever I talk about Pakistan, many people get upset. जब भी मैं पाकिस्तान के बारे में बात करता हूँ तो कुछ लोग नाराज हो जाते हैं. सो इट इन इज देयर हैबिट दैट व्हेनेवर आई विल टॉक अबाउट दैट पर्टिकुलर कंट्री सम पीपल विल गेट एंग्री. कुछ लोग क्या हो जाएंगे, एंग्री हो जाएंगे. व्हेनेवर सचिन ओपन्स फॉर द इंडिया ही गेट्स आउट अर्ली. जब भी सचिन भारत के लिए ओपनिंग करते हैं वो जल्दी आउट हो जाते हैं. सो व्हेन एंड व्हेनेवर के साथ हम इस तरह के सेंटेंसेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट हम फॉर्म कर सकते हैं. स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेनेवर ही बॉल्स द फर्स्ट ओवर ही गेट्स द विकेट. जब भी वो पहला ओवर फेंकता है उसे विकेट मिल जाता है. व्हेनेवर आई टेक्स द क्लास इन द इवनिंग, यू नो वेरी फ्यू स्टूडेंट्स ज्वाइन द क्लास. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, जब भी मैं क्लास शाम को लेता हूं तो बहुत कम स्टूडेंट ज्वाइन करते हैं. सो दीज टाइप ऑफ सेंटेंसेज यू कैन यूज विद द हेल्प ऑफ व्हेन एंड व्हेनेवर इन प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट. स्टूडेंट, इस तरह का आप सेंटेंस जो है यूज कर सकते हैं व्हेन और व्हेनेवर की, व्हेनेवर का यूज करके. सो लेट्स वन लास्ट पॉइंट वी विल टॉक अबाउट. लास्ट eighth point, students, that is conditional sentence. Now we will study about the conditional sentence in all three tenses. Students, conditional sentence for present is different, past is different, and future is different, and different ideas are expressed through these different sentences. For example, by using the conditional sentence in present tense, we express the reality that if something happens, if one condition fulfills, agar ek condition pura ho jata hai, then automatically the next work or next condition will be fulfilled. It is natural. For example, if you ask me to help, I will help you. So in this sentence you can see, students, we always use if for in the conditional sentence. If you ask me for help, I will help you. Also remember, students, when we form conditional sentences in present indefinite, first part in which the if has been used, jisme you if ka use hota hai, that part should be in present indefinite. Wo part kis tense mein hona chahiye? Present indefinite. And the later part of the sentence should be in the future tense, future indefinite tense. वो दूसरा पार्ट किस में होना चाहिए? फ्यूचर इंडिफिनिट होना चाहिए. थ्रू सच कंडीशन, स्टूडेंट्स, वी एक्सप्रेस द पॉसिबिलिटी दैट इफ समथिंग हैपेंस, द नेक्स्ट विल ऑटोमेटिकली हैपन. सपोज दैट, और यू कैन से इट विल डेफिनेटली हैपन. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ यू आस्क मी, आई विल हेल्प यू. सो आई विल हेल्प यू फॉर दैट कंडीशन इज दैट फर्स्ट यू आस्क मी, पहले तुम मुझसे कहो हेल्प के लिए. आई विल, if it rains, I will not go outside. So for condition for me not going outside is that if it rains. So if it rains, I will not go outside. So if one condition is fulfilled, and the first condition is what, students? That if it rains, I will not go outside. So the first, if this first condition is fulfilled, students, pehla condition jo hai, if it rains, shart ye hai ki agar barish hogi, so the next condition that I will not go outside is certain, that main bahar bilkul bhi nahi jaunga. So such conditional sentences are also used, or you can also form with the help of present indefinite, which are very important. And I know in definitely as a students, several occasion there will be there that you have to use such conditional sentence in your description, in your writing, or in your spoken English. Aapko spoken English mein bolna padta hai. So these were the points, 8 point, students, for which you can use or you should use present indefinite tense. Jiske liye hum kiska use karna chahiye? Present indefinite ka. So if you have any doubts about any points, now you can ask your question. I am allowing you to ask and listen the commentary on radio. So you might have observed that commentators are using the present indefinite in the most of the cases, because we don't have time to think about the particular tense and then describe the events. So it's quite easy to describe the events with the help of present indefinite. Therefore, commentators are generally they use the present indefinite in their commentary. For example, if the ball goes into the air, he plays the shot, ball goes into the air, he catches it safely, he dives, but he, you know, so like this, Dhoni dives to his right and takes the catch, he runs for a single. So these way you can use, you know, you must have seen, must have observed, must have heard the commentators using present indefinite in their commentary or for the commentary work. So that was the third point, students. Now I hope you understood all the points when you can use present indefinite tense. Now we will talk about present continuous, students. The points or situations are when you can use present continuous. Why are you not writing? I will come here to just see it, but no. You don't have pen. You are student now. Okay, I will just talk to your father. Don't worry. So, students, now let's see. Now we will talk about the present continuous. You know, present continuous, when any work that is going on, if at the time of speaking, जब भी हम बोल रहे होते हैं और उसी समय कोई work चल रहा है, like that, you all are attending the live classes, online classes. So, same time when I am speaking, you all are attending the class. आप उसी समय क्या कर रहे हो? Class को अटेंड कर रहे हो. सो इन सच सिचुएशंस वी यूज प्रेजेंट कंटीन्यूअस टेंस. लाइक फैन इज रनिंग अबव माय हेड, सो एट द टाइम ऑफ स्पीकिंग द फैन इज आल्सो रनिंग. फैन उसी समय क्या हो रहा है? चल रहा है, रन कर रहा है. आई एम टीचिंग एट द सेम टाइम व्हेन आई एम सेइंग दिस सेंटेंस, आई एम डूइंग द वर्क ऑफ टीचिंग. मैं इस काम को कर भी रहा हूँ. सो व्हाइल स्पीकिंग व्हाट एवर इज गोइंग ऑन, बोलते समय जो भी काम चल रहा है, दैट इज प्रेजेंट कंटीन्यूअस. एंड एक्सेप्ट दैट वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज present continuous in other situations. So let's see. First situation is that if anything that is going on at the time of speaking, as far as structure is concerned, I have already told you about it. Like what we use is am, are, and verb ing form. So this is the structure of present continuous. And now we are talking about when we can use. So at the time of speaking, if any work is going on, means it's continuous, students. Going on means the work is continue, jari hai. If work is going on at the time of speaking, so this is the first point. If work is going on at the time of speaking, we can use present continuous. I gave you the example, like children are playing. So when I say this sentence, at the very same time, children are playing somewhere, कहीं खेल रहे हैं. He is singing a song. When I say this sentence that he is singing a song, at the very same time, someone is singing a song. If students are talking, then when I say this sentence, the very same time some students are talking. So whenever, whatever we are saying, and the very at very same time something is going on, so for that we use present continuous. Uske liye hum kiska use karte hain? Present continuous ka, with the help of these helping verbs. And main verb should be always there should be always verb ing form in the main verb. So now the second point is that, students, work continue in regular process. There are so many work, students, which we do not do at the time of speaking. कई ऐसे work हैं जो हम बोलते समय नहीं कर रहे हैं, but at the regular basis we are doing that work. For you can say that in the evening, if somebody asks you what you are doing nowadays, so you can say nowadays I am attending online classes. So it may be that time when you are saying you are not attending the online class, but it is continuing the regular process. On the daily basis you are attending the online class. Daily basis pe aap online class attend kar rahe hain. It may be that when you are telling about this to someone, that time you are not attending. Matlab bolte samay zaruri nahi ki wo kaam aap kar rahe ho, but wo process mein chal raha hai. Like आई एम राइटिंग अ नॉवेल nowadays. मैं एक उपन्यास लिख रहा हूँ आजकल. मे बी एट द टाइम ऑफ स्पीकिंग आई एम नॉट राइटिंग द नॉवेल, बट इट इज कंटिन्यू इन द प्रोसेस. वो प्रोसेस में चल रहा है. सो फॉर सच सेंटेंसेज वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस. स्टूडेंट्स, द वर्क विच इज इन द प्रोसेस, वर्क इन द प्रोसेस. जो भी वर्क किसमें है, प्रोसेस में है, चल रहा है, उसके लिए भी हम किसका यूज कर सकते हैं, प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस का. आई गिव यू द एग्जांपल्स. ही इज नाउ टेकिंग ट्रेनिंग एट द तेंदुलकर एकेडमी, सहवाग एकेडमी. सो ही, इट इज नॉट समथिंग दैट व्हेन आई एम सेइंग दिस ही इज जस्ट प्लेइंग द गेम एंड टेकिंग द ट्रेनिंग. ही इज इन्वॉल्विंग द ट्रेनिंग, बट ही इज इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ लर्निंग थिंग्स एट दैट ट्रेनिंग सेंटर. वो सीख रहा है आजकल एनीथिंग दैट इज इन द प्रोसेस. I think it should be clear. So two points we have studied where you can use present continuous tense. Now let's talk about the third point, students. When we have planned something, personal planning. I just spoke about the planned work that for which the date is fixed. It is decided that somebody will retire on particular date. For that we can use present indefinite. If IPL starts next week, date is fixed for the IPL matches, IPL tournament, so we can use present indefinite. But here we can also use the present continuous for the planned work, but it should be personal. Like if I have make personal plan that tomorrow I will go to watch a see cinema, main kal cinema dekhne jaunga, so for that sentence I can also use present continuous. Us sentence ke liye main present continuous ka bhi use kar sakta hu because it's my personal planning. For example, let's understand it through example. It will be better. For that, suppose I have made a plan to watch a movie tomorrow. मैंने कल के लिए plan बनाया. That is my personal plan कि मैं कल क्या देखूंगा, एक movie देखूंगा. So for that purpose, we can also use present continuous. We can write like this: I am going to watch a movie tomorrow. I am going to watch movie tomorrow. Now see, students, this is showing the future time. Although the sentence is showing the action that will take place in future, jo action ki, woh action ki baat kar raha hai jo kab hoga, future mein hoga. But since it is the planned work, it's the rule of the grammar, it's the rule of the tense that if you have any personal planning, it should be your personal, you have decided it. For that you can use both. You can also use future indefinite, you can also use present continuous. There is nothing wrong about it. Isme kuch galat nahi. I think it should be clear. So these were the three points of present continuous, students, where we can use present continuous and where generally present continuous is used, present continuous tense is used. So let me remind all those three points. First point was that about at the any work that is going on at the time of speaking. Second point was that any work that is not going on at the time of speaking, but it is in the process, wo chal raha hai on the daily basis, process mein hai. And the third is that if you have any personal planning that we will do in future, for that we can also use present continuous. So these were the points of present continuous. If you have any doubt about it, you can ask your question. So pehle se question pooch lo aap, agar kuch puchna hai. Rule or first point says that at the time of speaking, when a work is going on, we use present continuous. But a work I might be doing at the regular basis, koi kaam main regular basis pe kar raha hu, maybe at the time of speaking I am not doing, ho sakta hai ki jab main bol raha hu uske bare mein nahi kar raha hu, but it is still continue on the regular basis. So for that we can also use, for example, I am attending the online classes nowadays. Maybe when you are telling this information to anyone or about it to anyone, that time you are not attending the class, but it is in the process that you on the daily basis from particular time, at the particular time you attend the online class. This is what I was talking about, students. Is it clear? Is it clear? Oh, you can, I can't hear you because I have muted you all. So I think, I hope it should be clear. So we have 6 minutes more, students. So let's talk about the present perfect, and I hope it would be finished on the time. Now we will talk about present perfect, students. So as far as structure of present perfect is concerned, you know that in present perfect we use has, have, along with the verb third form. When we use has, have, there are two helping verb. So let me also clear. When the person is third and it's singular. When the subject is in the third person and it is singular, we use has, and with the rest of the subject we use have. So it should be, this is the first thing, should be clear to you. Now we will talk about where we use present indefinite. So first one, point is to show work started in past and still it is continue when we use or say. Any work, students, that started in past, koi bhi work jo past mein shuru hua, for you can say, I have taken class for 3 hours. I have taken class for 30 minutes. So I started taking class before 30 minutes and still I am taking. For that purpose, I can also use present perfect. कोई भी वर्क जो शुरू हुआ और अभी भी चल रहा है, यू कैन से दैट आई हैव स्टडीड सिंस मॉर्निंग. इसके लिए भी आप यूज कर सकते हो कि मैं सुबह से पढ़ रहा हूँ, मतलब पढ़ना मेरा कब शुरू हुआ था, इन द मॉर्निंग एंड स्टिल इज कंटिन्यू. मेनी ऑफ यू मस्ट बी थिंकिंग दैट सर दिस इज व्हाट वी यूज इन द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस, दैट वर्क स्टार्टेड, द वर्क स्टार्टेड at the particular point of time or period of time and still it is going on. For that we use present perfect continuous. But let me tell you, students, that if anything that started in past and it is still continuing present, for that we can use both tense. Dono tense ka use kar sakte hain and both are right. Dono kya hai? Sahi hai. We can use present perfect for that as well, and for that we can also use present perfect continuous. Let me give you example. Suppose that मुझे ये कहना है कि वो 3 घंटे से पढ़ रहा है. It means he started studying before 3 hours and still he is studying. वो अभी भी क्या कर रहा है? पढ़ रहा है. For that I can use or we can use both tenses, present perfect and present perfect continuous. Like he has studied. He has studied for 3 hours. It means also that he is engaging in the study for 3 hours. So 3 ghantas pad raha hai. And this is also right. And if I write like this, he has been studying for 3 hours. This is also right. So don't be confused. You have choice to use both sentences whenever you have a work that whenever you are to describe such events of somebody who started any work or any event some times ago and he is still doing that work, he is still engaged in that event. So you can use both tenses for that. You can use present perfect as well as present perfect continuous. So students, for today I think it should be clear. It should be enough because you have very less time, 2 minutes more only. One more, students, here you can see I have time to tell you about this. I have used for. You know, in present perfect, since and for is used. So when we use since and when you use for, let me tell you about it. Main aapko isme bata deta hu briefly, jaldi se. Since is used when, students, we cannot count the time. Although you must have read in your book, since is used for the point of time. जब भी point of time की बात होती है तो हम उसका since का use कर सकते हैं. But clearly in a very simple language, if a time is there for to which you cannot count or which you cannot count. अगर कोई ऐसा समय आपके पास है जिसको आप count नहीं कर सकते. For example, Sunday. वो संडे से क्लास अटेंड कर रहा है. सपोज दैट वी आर टू मेक सेंटेंस विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस. सो संडे इज द टाइम यू कैन नॉट काउंट, इट इज द डे ऑफ ए वीक. ये जो डे है एक वीक का. सो व्हेनेवर अ टाइम इज देयर व्हिच यू कैन नॉट काउंट, वी यूज सिंस. उसके लिए हम किसका यूज कर सकते हैं? टाइम दैट इज नॉट काउंटेबल, नॉट काउंटेबल. टाइम, वो टाइम जिसको हम काउंट नहीं कर सकते हैं, इज नॉट काउंटेबल. सिंपल लैंग्वेज आप समझ लीजिए, जो टाइम आप गिन नहीं सकते हो उसके लिए सिंस का यूज करना and the time which we can count for 2 hours, 1 and 2, we can count here. So the time which is countable, we use for. उसके लिए हम किसका use करते हैं? For का use कर सकते हैं. So that's enough for today, students. If you have any query, if you have any doubt, please ask your question because we are running out of time.